been said that I don't show enough information about how I connected this coax to this board. And just to clarify that, I'm hoping that you can see this. The coax, the hole in this piece of plastic was big enough for this coax to go in there, and this is where the original antenna came out. So I found, in my situation, I did not have to connect the outer shield to ground. The outer shield is this foil and braided wire that's on the outside of this center connector. That center wire, that piece of copper right there, was soldered to the circuit board right here where the original antenna was connected. I unsoldered that purple antenna wire and soldered this copper wire in its place. And then I cut off the shield and that foil and then reinstalled this. And what I did was cut that coax like this, soldered this to the circuit board, and I cut this foil and the shield off. Had I found it necessary to connect this to ground, I could either strip this back and make this longer, I come over here and connect it to a screw, something that's metal. This is plastic, it's a bad place to connect it. Connect it to ground. Or I could solder a wire to this and then run that wire to here and connect it to ground. I did not find that necessary, and I'll show you how to strip this coax. That's quite easy. One thing further, I have seen a couple of these garage door openers that have a terminal sticking out here for connecting external antenna, in which case you would have a fitting like this on the end of your coax, and you would just screw that onto that, and away you go. Some of the external antenna kits that are being sold would already have these connectors on the end of the wire, although the length of the wire in some of those kits can be quite short. Show you how to prepare the end of this coax without any special tools. If you have an old piece of coax, just cut the end off, get back to fresh material. We're going to cut this back quite a ways to expose the braided shield. Bring this back, cut it off with a knife or nippers or a scissors. Just cut the outer covering. Try not to damage the braid. Take something like an ice pick. Just come in here and gently start unbraiding this outer shield in a straight line, in as much as possible. Bring it all down here by the rubber coating and just twist it. Sometimes this foil is stuck to the inner core. Get it back here and sometimes it will break off, otherwise you cut it off. We only need a sharp length of the center copper. I just take a sharp knife, I come in here and I just score this inner core. And I want to do that without nicking the copper. Then I twist that and then pull it off. And that's all there is to it. We only need about this much. We'll push this up as close as we can to the circuit board, solder that to the circuit board, and then cut off the excess, so it doesn't stick out past the solder side. If necessary, we can attach this to ground. If this is not long enough, we can solder this right here and solder a flexible wire to it and take that to a ground connection. The purpose of the shield is to prevent extraneous signals from getting to a receiver. And by connecting this to ground, we make this an effective shield for the center conductor. In my case, I didn't find that it made any difference. These garage door openers don't seem to be very high tech, and the signal received does not seem to be sensitive to antenna length. On the other end of the wire that was outside, I cut this off. I soldered the original purple wire to this and put some heat shrink on here And the only reason I put the original antenna wire on here is it was a flexible wire. This wire is very stiff and is prone to breaking or getting kinked. That original wire was very flexible and not as likely to get damaged over the years. So that's why I did that. How you do it is strictly up to you. If the shield is grounded, you will need a length of wire soldered to this copper, roughly equivalent to the length of the original antenna wire you removed from the door opener.